morning. We are on the Ives Trail, just west of the Route 7 highway. About a 7 mile hike in through Danbury to Bethel, back again. And we have two pretty good hills to hike. And we're just getting started, so let's get going. Nice little climb here. Coming up along the stream to the top of the hill. Going up the last ascent to this hill. I think it's Worcester Hill, the first hill to cross over on the Ives Trail. There's a break in the ridgeline up ahead, and we'll cut through that. Pretty shot with the sun as we come up the ridge here. So we're descending up the mountain. Some nice little steps here, but it gets a little rugged further down in the ravine. Last video, everything was looking down, so let's show a little bit of canopy here. The ravine as we get down to the bottom of the mountain here. And with the wetlands, you get more bugs. Why do they like your ears? I don't know. Well, they like mine. Going up on this little rugged section here, crossing a little boulder field. So we're road walking. This is the, I think the last mile and a half to Bethel is on this old road. We're out of the hills, and it'll be relatively flat. A little boring, but it's part of the trail. And it is pretty secluded here. A little ravine here, a little stream. And there's the sun. It's gonna be in the upper 90s today. It'll be hot. Nice little water course. Onward. Getting close to the terminal of the southern portion of the Ives Trail in Bethel. Maybe a quarter mile out to the road. Then we turn around. Okay, I'm back to the parking lot. I finished my hike for the day of the Ives Trail on the west section. Did 11.2 miles out and back, and that was about 6 hours nonstop, and about 1,300 plus feet in elevation, so a lot of up and down. It was pretty tiring. It was around 95, hot day. I'm pretty tired and hungry, and looking forward to go home and get some lunch. Okay, thanks for watching.